In this video, I'm going to show you the absolute easiest way to blur the background realistically in Photoshop. So here's a great travel shot. Let's add a realistic blur filter, neural filters. Once the gallery pops open, we're going to want to use Def Blur. Now, if you see the little cloud icon, click on that and it will download the filter for you. And just click to apply it. What happens is Adobe uses its AI, which is Adobe Sensei, to detect the edges. Now, this is not the final result, but you can see it's done a pretty decent job of detecting those edges. So the essential settings that we want to do is we're going to change the focal range. Let's pull this down to about the middle. And see what it's doing is it's extending our depth of field a little bit further out. Let's go a little bit more. I think there's pretty good. Now you might want to change the blur strength. You could reduce the amount of blur, or of course you can increase it. The other option you have is to add a little bit of haze. The last setting you might look at is grain. So if your photo itself is a little bit grainy, and then the blur obviously is going to be very, very smooth, you can just pull in a little bit of grain to match the grain of your photo, and you're going to get a much more realistic result. Now, right now we've got this set to focus subject. You can actually turn that off, and you can click on the background and say, hey, you know what? I want the background to be in focus and the foreground to be blurry, or you can literally focus this wherever you want by just simply clicking on the photograph. Just click OK to apply. Because I applied this to a smart filter, it becomes a smart object. We can see there's before and there is after. Here's a question for you guys. Do you like to travel? What was the last trip you made? Let us know in the comments underneath. And if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Subscribe and turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And if you guys got any value out of this, do me a favor, hit that like button, a thumbs up. It helps with the YouTube algorithm. And so until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.